Good morning, students. So today we have to study about the next topic of this chapter, and this is about metalloids and inert gases. So let's start with this topic. What are metalloids? So as the name is suggesting, the metalloids will share the properties of both metals and non-metals. These will share the properties of both metals and non-metals. So, metalloids is a type of chemical element which has a preponderance of properties in between or that or of mixture of those metals and non-metals. So, metalloids will share the properties of both metals as well as non-metals. And this is the reason we don't have a standard definition for metalloids and no complete agreement on which elements are metalloids. So, these metalloids are basically found at the middle part of the periodic table. Okay, so this side is the metals, this side is the non-metals, and at the extreme right side there is inert elements. So one of the metalloid is silicon. It is not found in free state. Silicon is the second most abundant element. First most abundant element is the aluminium. So, second most abundant element, most abundant it means found in more quantity as compared to the other elements. And why it is the second most element? Because most abundant element, because it is found in sand. So, what is the chemical name for sand? That is silicon dioxide. What is the chemical formula for sand? That is SiO2. Pure silicon is used in microchips of the computer. Pure silicon is also used for transistor, for making solar cells, for making rectifiers, and it is also used in the electronic and space age industries. Silicon is the material which is artificially prepared and it is waterproof. And this silicon is used to make bags, umbrellas and raincoats. Then the another artificially prepared material or substance compound is the silicon carbide. So, it is the hardest compound prepared by man, and that is why it is used in making of grinding tools. So, since it is hardest, so that is why it is used for making grinding tools. Then the other is sand. So, in the form of sand, silicon is used for the preparation of glass, concrete, bricks and cement. Then next is silicates, compound of silica, that will be used in the enamel and the pottery industry. Silicon steel is an alloy with silica and iron, so it is used in electric appliances. Next metalloid is the germanium. So germanium is lustrous, it means they will have shine, they are hard and they are grayish white metal. It is used as semiconductor, it is used in the transistors, it is used for making different types of alloys, and in the fluorescent lamps as phosphor. Then the other last metalloid which you have to study according to your syllabus is antimony. Antimony is used in the electric industry to make semiconductor devices. Then alloy of antimony with lead is used in making of batteries because it becomes hard. As a typing metal, it is used in the printing press. Antimony is also used in the paint, enamel, glass and pottery industry. Next we have to see is the inert gas. And why these gases? Inert gas because it is found in the gaseous state. Inert because they are chemically inactive. And why they are chemically inactive? Because they have completely fulfilled octet. So their outermost cell is completely filled with 8 electrons. And the only duplet inert element is helium. Why duplet? Because it is having only one shell and that first cell is filled with 2 electrons, so that is why it is the only duplet element. So inert gas is a gas that does not undergo any chemical reaction. Why? Because their octet is filled, so they don't require any electron, they don't need to give any electron, they don't have any extra electron in the outermost cell, so that is why they will not undergo any chemical reaction in a given set of conditions. They are also known as noble gases. Why they are known as noble gases? Because they do not react with many substances, and that is why historically they were referred to as inert gases. Inert gases are generally used to avoid unwanted chemical reactions or degrading a sample. So if you don't want any chemical reaction to occur over a place, which gas should be used? There we can use inert gases, which will prevent the unwanted chemical reactions over there. So here are these inert elements, that is helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon and radon. Helium is the second lightest metal. First lightest metal is hydrogen. And since it is inactive, so that is why it is used in filling of the air balloons or weather balloons. Then argon. Argon, because of its inert nature, it is used in filling of bulbs, electric bulbs. Neon. Neon is used in advertising signboards or the tube lights on the roadsides. You must have seen the signboards. Radon is a radioactive inert element which is used in cancer treatment. And xenon and krypton is the another inert element which is used in the photography. So this is all for today. Your homework is to write down the uses of all the metalloids which we have discussed and of the inert elements. Thank you, everyone.